Hey, welcome to Bishop Justice. Another great week, another day on this earth that God has given us to be here and bless somebody. I thank you for all your letters and all your phone calls. I'm feeling about 100% better than I was last time with all that pollen bothering me and the hay fever, but I'm feeling great now. So let's get it on with the Bible verse. You know, we got to start off with Bishop Justice with the Bible verse. We're going to go to Proverbs 19:17. Whoever is generous to the poor lends to the Lord, and he will repay him for his deed. That is Proverbs 19:17. Again, thank you for all your calls, your comments, and God bless. We hope God grant you all your wishes and your desires. Got a couple quick announcements. 12 May at 11 a.m., 3481 Wrightsboro Road. We're going to do a meet and greet with Bishop Justice, yours truly, and one of the actors of Tyler Perry's movies. M.V. Olivant will be there to sign autographs. I'll be to sign autographs. We'll start at 11 o'clock. We're going to probably run to 11 to about 5 or however long M.V. Olivant can give us his time. And all our past guests from the Bishop Justice show will be there. Also, we got two new brand new sponsors. Thank God for them. Maryland Fried Chicken, 12 Broad Street, Augusta, Georgia, 706-722-2051. Maryland Fried Chicken. That ad will air at the end of the show, so you can see it and call them and patronize. Oh, go down there and get you some chicken. If you like me, I love chicken. Gerald Jones Honda, 4022 Washington Road, Martinez, Georgia, 30907. And we're going to talk about some of the specials they have very quickly at Gerald Jones Honda, because one of my very, very special guests today is from Gerald Jones Honda and a lifelong friend of mine. Well, at Gerald Jones Honda, you got an LX Civic, only $149 a month for 36 months, an LX Accord, $169 for 36 months, CRV LX, $239 for 36 months. But guess what? Well, actually, if you go ask for James Williamson, who's going to be my guest today, we'll get to see him shortly. They'll wash your car every Saturday for free for the lifetime you have the car. You can't beat that. Somebody's going to wash your car for free every Saturday. Now, with all that pollen in the air and the things going on, you can't beat that. Plus, hold up now, I just almost missed something. Plus a cruise, 5-day, 4-night cruise. Well, I'll let James talk about that later. I think it's cruise, 5-day, 4-night cruise that you can get. So I think we'll let James talk about that in just a minute. But as Gerald Jones Honda, see James Williamson, tell him that Bishop Justice sent you, you'll get $500 off the price of a new car. You can't beat that. Let me see what else we got, announcements we have. Make sure I didn't miss anybody. Okay, without further ado, again, I'd like to say thank you for all your well wishes and comments that you sent in to Bishop Justice in my P.O. box and the phone calls I got from my missionaries in Africa, New Zealand, and Australia. Thank you, and God bless you. Bishop has never forgot about you. Whatever prayer request you asked to send in to me, I have done. So we hope you got all your wishes and all your desires in the Lord. With that, without further ado, I have a lifelong friend here on TV today. James Williams with Gerald Jones Honda. You used to elbow me in the head at Bernie Ward Gym, but I'm not mad at him. He was just teaching me a lesson to get tough. That's all he was saying, get tough. You're going to get in the paint, get tough. And I always remember that lesson playing all Army basketball and everything I did in life, to get tough and to be strong and keep the Lord in your life. He's never, ever said any derogative thing towards me. I've never, ever heard him say anything derogative. And I always know that his respect and his admiration and community is just as high as it can get. And with that, James, thank you for taking time out to come here. Appreciate it.
Good to see you.
I saw your picture. In Augusta Chronicle, James Williamson leads a class at the Augusta Care Pregnancy Center aimed at building positive ideas about marriage. that class is held every Thursday. We have to rebuild the concept of marriage in their mind. Owner Susan Swanson says. We'll get to that in just a minute. Well, but let's talk about, in case I missed something, tell me what's going on. And first of all, tell me who James Williamson is, and then we'll get to talking about what's going on in Gerald Dillon's family.
Well, James Williamson is a man, a husband of a beautiful wife who I've been married to for the last 14 years. I have three beautiful daughters that I'm very, very proud of. And just trying to do the will of God, just trying to do whatever God is calling me to do when it comes to the youth.
Right.
So that's, in a nutshell, who James Williamson is. I'm from New York City.
Right.
And I came down here to go to Payne College, and I just felt that when I said, if I ever get married, I don't think I want to raise a family in New York. So right. I stayed down here. I didn't want to raise. So right. Thank God I met my wife down here.
Yeah, amen.
And we stayed down here. And I actually felt I really got my calling when it comes to knowing what I needed to do or what my purpose was while I was here. And that was being that I needed to be called to teach the youth and try to help them become better citizens and try to find out what they need to do in their life. So.
You know, when I met you, now, I'm from the Bronx. What part of New York are you from?
Manhattan.
Oh, Manhattan. I'm not. Mm. Okay. Because if you were from Queens, I didn't want to talk to you anymore. I don't like folks from Queens. I was born in the Bronx, but I grew up on 172nd Street in Manhattan. I came from White Rock Baptist Church, which is my godparents, Ashford and Simpson. Mm-hmm. My godfather just died. And Nick Ashford, he just died. And then we had Freddie Jackson and Melba Moore.
Wow.
Was at our church. Mm-hmm. And it started out in the choir.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where I came from. And
wow.
I was called the Miracle Baby of White Rock Baptist Church.
Mm-hmm.
But because I was born premature to a single mother.
Mm-hmm.
Back then, if you born premature to a single mother, and I had lung problems, health care was like absolutely zero.
Yeah, that's
so
right. That's
the
right.
Life
that's
expectancy
right.
was zero.
That's right. That's right.
So
that's
they
right.
called me the Miracle Baby at White Rock Baptist Church. But anyway, enough about me. You're at Gerald Jones Honda, because we're going to talk about something else here later on.
Mm-hmm.
But you're at Gerald Jones Honda, and they have a great reputation.
They do.
And by the way, I like your outfit.
Thank you, sir.
You always been a star.
Thank you, sir.
You know what? I told my wife yesterday, I said when I was coming up, I always used to see James, and he was always dapper. And for 10 years, I wore a suit and tie.
That's right. That's
because
right.
of you.
Oh
yeah, because I used to see you wear a suit
that's
and tie.
Right, that's
so
right.
I wore a suit and tie every day for 10 years.
Oh, my goodness.
And then that later period of my life, I would act like a bum.
That's right.
I got to the jeans and T-shirt
that's
phase
right,
of my
right,
life.
That's right.
But I had a lot of money in my pocket.
That's right. That's right.
But I think when I wore the suit and tie, I didn't have no money in my pocket. Mm-hmm. I had more money in my pocket when I wore the jeans.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
But the theory is look like a million
look
bucks.
Look like that's right. Look,
so,
that's right. That's right. That's right.
You at Gerald Jones Honda.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about the specials that are going on there and how you like working there at Gerald Jones Honda. What's going on?
Well, I've been there for now 8 years.
8 years.
And I'm excited about being there. The owner is a great owner to work for. Mm-hmm. Mr. Gerald's a very humble, wonderful, wonderful man. Andy, his son, has taken over, so now Andy takes over the operations of the business, but he's a great person to work for. He's a Christian also, so it's really, it's been a blessing to work there.
Mm-hmm.
God has allowed me to meet a lot of people while I'm there. You know, I was working for Toyota for 7 years also, Mr. Bourne sold the company, I came over to work for Mr. Gerald Jones. And so it's been really a blessing there. We're having great sales going on, like you were saying.
Yeah.
We have the LX Civic for only $149 a month. We have the Honda Accord for $169 a month, 36-month specials. You also have the CRV for $239 a month. And like I was saying, the great thing about it, we wash your car every Saturday for free for as long as you own your car.
Right.
And we have the 5-day, 4-night cruise to the Bahamas for free also. That's for two.
That's if you buy a car?
I don't care if you buy a $2,000 car, you still get
it. If I get a $2,000 car, I can go on a 5-day, four-night
cruise to the Bahamas.
I don't need to let my wife hear that. She'll make me just buy a used car, just go
that's
on
right.
the cruise.
That's right. It's a great cruise. I have customers who came back from there, and they had a great time. They went over to the Atlantis while they were there on the cruise. Yeah. So it's a great time. It's a great.
Well, I don't know if I need to let my wife hear about that, because she just had me come buy a used car just go on the cruise. But, you know, I know Gerald Jones Honda's a good franchise. That's they got
right.
a Gerald Jones Honda, Volvo, I think.
That's
and
right,
they got
that's right.
Several
Audi.
Audi and
Subaru. And, yeah, we have about five.
So they know about you here today, don't they?
No, they might.
They might. Yeah. They're going to see you on TV talking about them once you get all these sales coming in.
That's right.
Coming
that's
to see right. James Williamson.
That's
get,
right.
Ask for the $500. They got to say Bishop Justice, though.
That's right. They got to say Bishop Justice.
Bishop Justice.
That's
get
right.
the $500 off on a brand new car.
That's right.
And then they get their cruise.
Mm-hmm.
And then I think there's something else you had.
Wash
on
the
there.
Car.
Then wash the car.
Wash the
that's
car
right.
Saturday.
Wash the car every Saturday.
For
forever.
Long as, for long as they own the vehicle.
That man, you can't beat that.
You can't beat that.
Can't beat that.
You save about $500 a year on that.
Okay, that is something else.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's go to something else that you do, and mm-hmm. I'm really, really amazed that you do this, because mm-hmm. I remember. I don't know if you remember. I came to Wilkinson Gardens.
I remember.
You asked me to come down to Wilkinson Gardens, speak
right.
to the, I think the boys and girls.
That's right.
Down there.
That's right.
And like any friend of mine, anytime you ask me to come, I'm gonna
that's
come.
Right. That's right.
But I went down to Wilkinson Gardens. I enjoyed every mm-hmm. time I went to Wilkinson Gardens to speak mm-hmm. to those kids.
Mm-hmm.
It was just amazing,
mm-hmm.
and they were so politeful and mm-hmm. so courteous. Mm-hmm. A lot of times people think kids are, you know, a certain way.
Mm-hmm.
They treated me with utmost respect.
Mm-hmm.
I think you prepped them ahead of time. that's what I think. But anyway, they were just so nice to me.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll talk about your volunteer work. And tell me about the name of your organization that I think you and your wife had.
That's
that,
right. Now, that's actually, that. Yeah, well, that's actually called Positive Images,
an uh-huh.
Organization that my wife and I started right in our, actually in our living room.
Uh-huh.
We had teenagers coming over to the house, and we would teach them life skills and things
right.
of that nature. And then, like I said, and that's and of course I've been working with communities and schools also for the last 7 to 8 years.
Right.
So I go out to, I actually have an opportunity to go into the high schools and talk to classes and to auditoriums
mm-hmm.
of the kids and just try to motivate them to try to be the best people they can be and actually to find out what their purpose is in life.
Right. I see that it says here that Augusta Care Pregnancy Center.
You that's
did.
Right.
So
that's
what
right.
is what is that
well,
all
well, Augusta
about?
Pregnancy Center, I actually teach a relationship class at mm-hmm. Augusta Pregnancy Center on Thursdays at 6 o'clock, 6 to 8 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
And what we do there is we promote marriage.
Okay.
A lot of the young ladies there are, may not be married at this time, but
right.
we promote marriage and tell them about marriage. Because
mm-hmm.
you have to know what the roles are in marriage. You
right.
have to know, you know, you just don't, you're just, when you're born, you just don't know what it is to be a husband, a father,
right.
A mother. You don't know those
right.
skills. They don't come natural. Those are things that are taught.
Right.
So that we do there is we teach them the skills, how to be a husband, how to be a father, what is a father, what is a man, what is a woman. So that's what we do on Thursday. We have a lot of positive feedback. The people that come enjoy the classes because it's a very, very open. And, you know, you actually want to talk in a safe environment, an environment where you don't have to worry about people judging you. And like you said, I hear every type of story imaginable, but it's you know, just the love of God can able to talk and really hear what the young ladies and young men are saying, and we it's a great program.
Well, you know, there's no manual on being married.
That's right.
You know, it's a lot of people think there. I don't know, for some reason, people
mm-hmm.
think there's a manual on
mm-hmm.
being married.
Mm-hmm.
I've been married all my adult life.
That's
and
right.
I'm still trying to figure.
That's
it
right,
out.
That's right. That's right.
And I'm
that's
a priest.
Right, that's right.
So I'm still trying to figure out what this thing is marriage.
That's right.
Called.
That's right. That's right.
You know, I love my wife, love
that's
my children,
right.
love
that's
my
right.
grandkids.
That's right.
But I'm still trying to figure out. I mean, because people are different,
mm-hmm.
and you got to be able to be flexible.
That's right. That's right.
A lot of people don't understand that. Mm-hmm. The reason I survived so long, I think, in a marital status is that I'm flexible.
Mm-hmm.
I've been. But I'm not gonna break.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, baby. Yes.
That's right.
But you know, but that at the end of the day, mm-hmm. you kind of, you know, you do what she says, but you still at the end of the day, as most men do, you're gonna do what you want to do. And I'm retired. You know, I'm ex-military. So at the end of the day, I learned how to, you know,
mm-hmm.
take some stuff in.
Mm-hmm.
I love my wife with all my
mm-hmm.
heart.
That's right.
But you know, a lot of things I just had to
mm-hmm.
say yes and
that's
do.
That's right.
To keep peace at home. But a lot of men don't want to do that.
That's right.
And I think that to keep peace at home, sometimes you got to bend. You, mm-hmm. you don't have to break. Mm-hmm. Just bend. Mm-hmm. And you don't have to be the dominant
That's right.
all the
That's
time.
Right. That's right.
My wife's a queen. Mm-hmm. I'm a king.
That's right. That's right.
And
That's
I always right. think it, to a great man mm-hmm. or no greater than that mm-hmm. woman beside
That's
him.
That's right. That's
and
true.
Nine times out of ten, that woman's probably greater than you anyway.
That's right. That's right.
That woman probably That's got right. more sense than you do.
That's right.
Because, you know, if we go out and do what we really want to do,
That's right.
it won't be no money in the bank. Won't be no food in the refrigerator. It probably never come home to the next day. But, you know, you can't do that. I'm just keeping it real.
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
but you know, the things that you're doing in the neighborhood mm-hmm. are just, I mean, great. I've been knowing you a long time.
That's right. That's right.
You've always been kind. Nice, cordial. Every time I see you, you're cordial, mm-hmm. you're sharp. I might be looking like a bum, but you're looking like a million bucks. And a lot of times I'm jogging and running and stuff,
that's
exercising.
Right, that's right, that's right.
And I have that flexibility nowadays to kind of pretty much do what I want to do. Mm-hmm. But I don't have to do the suit and tie thing every
that's right,
day.
That's right, that's right.
But and my wife gets mad at me because I walk out of the house, she's like, you're looking like a bum. I said, well, so what?
Yeah.
I kind of do what I want to do.
That's right, that's right, that's
but, you know, I don't think you always got to be trying to impress folks.
No, you don't.
You got to be human.
Be you. Be you.
And see, when I meet you all the time, you are always so nice and always cordial. You always got something going on with the youth. Mm-hmm. I mean, when I coached in the county for 10 years.
That's right.
And Rary had a very winning program
that's
in
right,
football
you did.
And basketball.
That's right, you did.
Winning as coach in Richmond County. But, mm-hmm. Whenever time I talk to you, anything I ask, anything you ask me, I did. Tell me more about what you got coming up on the horizon as far as with the volunteer work, what you and your wife are involved in.
Well, like I said, the thing about it is if you check the statistics, 7 out of 10 black homes don't have fathers.
Right.
And that's why I see the concern. That's why it's so important that I'm in the high schools like I am.
Right.
Because I was just in the high school yesterday, and I was talking to a class, and we were talking about the stages of life and how you go from a boy to a man to a husband and to a father.
Right.
And we were talking, and one of the young men stood up and said, you know, what do you do when your father is a drug dealer and all he knows is being a drug dealer and he teaches me how to sell drugs and you know do you call him a father? I'm just saying, so you know, he feels like because he's a felon he cannot do anything else but sell drugs. I'm just saying, so you these are the type of the situations that you have in the school systems where you have young men who growing up who hate their fathers because their fathers done left them and the father was never there. You have young ladies who because they don't have fathers, they're allowing themselves to be involved with young men who are not men yet, who they're giving their bodies to them. So you have a lot of this type of stuff going on right now in the school system with the teenagers, where they don't really have they don't have anybody there to love them and to give them the guidance and the direction that they need. Everybody needs guidance.
Right.
Everybody needs direction.
Right.
You know,
right.
I was talking to a young man at my job, and he was telling me about how his father used to have him up under the house and fixing stuff under the house and things of that nature. And now today he's fixing his own house. He's doing things in his own house. See, you don't have those type of men out there right now. You don't have men out there that would be able to, that were trained by other men and told what this is what a husband does right now. This is what a father does. This is what a man does. A man takes care of business.
Right.
They don't know none of this. That's why you have so many men that want to live with women and don't even understand they don't have to work, and the women work and the men don't work.
Right.
So
right.
See, this is a mindset of not knowing how to be a man. A man's supposed to be responsible. A man's supposed to take care of what he's supposed to take care of. A man is that's what a man does. But they don't know what a man is. They never see men.
Well, I think that, like you said, they don't see men.
They
see the women.
That's right.
There's so many things. But the excuse of being the convicted felon, I don't buy into that excuse. I have a good friend of mine who's a convicted felon. He's a judge now.
Exactly.
But in Atlanta, and he overcame that. And a lot of times people use that excuse of being a convicted felon. Really, to a person, a company can't use you being a felon against you. That's discrimination. Your criminal background, that's discrimination. if you, a lot of times you explain things that went what happened, mm-hmm. or whatever, whatever. Mm-hmm. You be honest with the people.
That's right.
The company.
That's right.
They'll hire you if you're honest, because you be.
That's right.
Believe it or not, the person who's interviewing you is probably a convicted felon himself.
And that's what I told his son that. That's what I told his son. I told his son the same thing. That's right. You can't use that as an excuse.
Yeah, you just don't never know. When a person could have gotten convicted as a crime, mm-hmm. 20 years ago, they're 50 or 60 and CEO of a company, mm-hmm. and got a felony status still on them.
That's right.
But they overcame man-made obstacles. But I hear that all the time about these things about being a convicted felon is holding them back. I don't buy into it. It's based on the person. How you carry yourself, mm-hmm. how you conduct yourself, mm-hmm. and are you doing the same things you did that got you the felon in the first place?
That's true.
I believe, I'm not judgmental now, James, mm-hmm. but I believe you made a mistake, mm-hmm. and you don't make that same mistake again, mm-hmm. I can live with it. Mm-hmm. But if you keep making that same mistake over and over and over and over again, well, ain't nobody gonna hire you, because you see the pattern on there that's saying you keep getting arrested for the same thing over and over. But they see a blemish in the record that says one time, and that person hired you got the blemish, same blemish, and you are, let's just say, you're a moneymaker.
That's right.
Because it's all about money.
That's right.
Unless you're into the nonprofit volunteer business like I am, then if you own your own company, then it really is about you. It's about James. It's about Bishop. And how are we going to try to make this world a better place? Well, I'm going to get into politics. We got a lot of political races going on right now. So what political race is on your mind? Who jumps out to make you vote or something?
No.
Anything?
No, I really have to do some more research on that to see who really that I'm going to actually be doing that for. I really don't. Like I said, most of my time is spent in schools and doing other stuff. So I really have.
Well, you got
to
vote now.
Yeah, I got to vote.
I'm not gonna ask you going to vote for. I'm saying what race intrigues you.
The sheriff race.
I know. Mm-hmm. I knew you were gonna say that. Mm-hmm. Something in my mind just told me. The sheriff race.
Yeah.
We had Captain Scott Peebles on, who's the leading vote getter. I mean, leading fundraiser for the sheriff race so far, and then we got. Lieutenant Robbie Silas called me the other day, so he's going to be on the show on the taping him on the 31st. We got Tyler Perry's people coming in next week, but Robbie Silas is coming in, and he's part of the group from where me and you come from, South Augusta, Green Meadows Estates. At that time I could have went to Butler. At that time you could pick where you want to go, Glen Hills or Butler, and so now they got it back now again where you can choose what school you want to go to. But Robbie Silas will be on, taping him on the 31st. But Scott Peoples was on. I think, like you said, this sheriff race is going to be something else. And it's going to be one of the most intriguing races, campaigns, that I've ever seen and will be a part of ever in the history of Richmond County. Because it's going to go right down black-white. That's all it's going to go. Everybody's going to play the race card. And I don't agree with that, but it's that's what's going to happen. I think congressional race, we had R.W. Allen on my show. They won't play the race card. Rick Allen's not that type of person anyway. And then you got the commissioner race. District 1 is going to be pretty interesting. Downtown, Matt Aiken and a white commissioner in a black, predominantly black district. So these the politics in Richmond County is. I've been a victim of politics in Richmond County, because if you're not on the right side of the coin, people will try to destroy you. Have you ever thought about getting in politics? Because you look like a governor.
No.
You look like a congressman.
Never thought about it. never wanted to throw my hat in the ring. Yeah. Never wanted
you
to
look
do
like
that.
You look like you'd be governor of Georgia. You look the part.
No.
I know you're a good man, because I know you'll do what's good for the people. Mm-hmm. A lot of times, my grandfather was first black elected mayor in the state of South Carolina, and he always did what was right for people. And I remember when he did not have public water in the house. I used to come down from New York City and visit my grandfather down in South Carolina every summer and when I was little. And they didn't have water. And so when the water finally came to that part of the state, he made sure everybody else had water before him. I said, Granddad, you the mayor. You should have got the water
first. That's right.
I'm still going out to the outhouse. He said, no. Take care of all the people first.
That's right.
and then I'll be fine.
That's a good philosophy.
And guess what? The water company to this day is named after him.
Wow, that's amazing.
Ain't that something?
That's something.
The water company is named after my grandfather. Mm-hmm. Ain't that something?
That's something.
So, I mean, you know, you think that people don't pay you any attention. Mm-hmm. James, I've been watching for a long time. I'm about to be on a cover of National Magazine. Mm-hmm. And I asked the people that when they called me, wanted my bio information, mm-hmm. I said, why me? Mm-hmm. They said, why not you? Mm-hmm. So when you think people not paying you attention,
that's right.
See, like I said, I looked at you in the mm-hmm. Newspaper. Mm-hmm. I said, I got to get James and I get him on the show. And, you know, but tell me what else is going on with the, what you got on the horizon? We talked politics, we talked a little business.
Well, another thing I do is I actually go to different schools. Like I said, I go to schools, and I'm available also to go to churches, to talk to the youth, to talk to teenagers. Because what I do is I actually teach an abstinence program also.
Okay.
So the abstinence program is something that, like I said, you know, when you have the state of how many young people are having kids out of wedlock.
Yeah.
The abstinence program is something that we talk about on a regular basis also.
Okay, did you give the TV station your contact information?
Yeah, it's, yeah.
You go ahead, so make sure they put up there. Mm-hmm. What's the name of the group? We got
to
bring to a close.
Born to be Great.
Born to be Great.
Yeah. And
what's the phone number?
It's 706-533-7481.
I'll make sure they post that. And we got to wrap it up. James, it's always a pleasure seeing you.
You too, young man.
You look like at the something of the cover of GQ magazine all the time. Ebony or Essence. I said, I grew up one day just like you. Well, we got to wrap up. Bishop Justice, one of my good friends is on here today, James Williamson. Make sure you go see him at Gerald Jones Honda. All his contact information will be on the screen. Please patronize him. They got the special. Make sure you say Bishop Justice. You get $500 off the new car. We also have the meet and greet on the 12th of May. Start at 11 a.m. 3481 Riceboro Road, the Raceway with Tyler Perry's people. Come out and support that. And please patronize my new sponsor. With that, hey, I'd like to say thank you for tuning in to Bishop Justice. I love you. God loves you. Bless someone as God has blessed me. Thank you. Until next time, I love you. Be blessed. Bishop Blessed.
There's no question of your greatness, no searching of your power. Oh, the wonder of your glory. To you, 40 years is but 1 hour. Your knowledge is all encompassing. To your wisdom, there is no end. Oh, for you alone are God. You are God. Mercy is everlasting. Your truth is here always. You are He who was and is to come. Who is He that can number your days? You flung the sun to burn in space, and the night's moon borrows light from day. You alone, your God, Elohim, you're everything I need. You are God alone. Now until the King,
now until the King,
eternal.
Time.